20 days and plenty madness into the 2018 FIFA World Cup, we are down to the final eight, which means only 7 matches remain to decide the course of that trophy. Here's confirmation of the quarterfinal lineup at Russia 2018. There's no Germany, no Spain, no Argentina, no Portugal, but it will still be a cracking start to the last eight, with France locking horns with Uruguay before Brazil and Belgium meet in a blockbuster battle on Friday. Saturday sees the other section of the draw in action, one deplete of any top 10 ranked side in the world, and so all surviving teams will harbour hopes of going the distance. Sweden face England before hosts Russia take on Croatia. Eugeneson Lyngdoh, quarterfinal number one is France against Uruguay. To many, before this, before the round of 16 started, this was the day they were going to see Ronaldo versus Messi lock-ons. That's not happening, but instead you have Griezmann and Mbappe against Suarez, but probably no Cavani.
Obviously, the two better teams got through the quarters, and yeah, we're going to see a team that's of great attacking caliber versus a team that has got good defense experience. So it's going to be interesting to see how Uruguay are going to play without Cavani because of his injury. So it's going to be a very enticing match, and we look to a lot of action forward.
That's followed, Ashley, by Brazil, Belgium, and a blockbuster battle. Lots of Bs, but an A-lister clash if ever there had to be one in the quarters.
Yeah, I think this will be an interesting one. Obviously, some big talent on show. Lukaku, Hazard, Mertens, you know, De Bruyne for Belgium. And then obviously the front three of Jesus. It's been looking, he's played most of the games. Obviously, Neymar and Willian on the right-hand side. So, you know, huge attacking prowess. And then you've also got the resolute defence of Brazil, so we're not quite sure what the tactics will be. We're pretty sure that Roberto Martinez won't change his. He likes the 3-4-3, and Brazil are having good joy at their 4-3-3. So let's see what that one's going to bring. But I hope it's open and entertaining. It seems it, you know, it's got all the ingredients to be. Roberto Martinez likes to attack. He also likes to concede. So let's look forward to that one.
Eugene, your expectations from Brazil versus Belgium? Belgium were leaky against Japan. Do you fear that if they open themselves up that way, Brazil aren't a side which will let them come back the way Japan did?
I think they will have to analyse themselves for what happened the previous game. You can't be giving the amount of space that they gave Japan. Willian, Neymar and Gabriel Jesus are going to hurt them. So I'm sure they're going to find solutions for that.
France versus Uruguay, I want to pick your brains on that one. Ashley, of course, Cavani's absence, as Eugene mentioned, could be so telling in that contest. But Uruguay have been a frustrating team to play, even outside of their attacking riches. How do France approach this game?
Yeah, I think Uruguay have this this desire and appetite to do what it takes to get results. We know that from Luis Suarez's character. You know, I've seen interviews from his childhood football team where he was exactly the same as a kid. So they're a tough nut to crack. They will miss Cavani. It'll be interesting for Griezmann. He obviously plays alongside Jimenez and Godin at club level for Atletico Madrid. So that'll be interesting for him. I think he classes himself as half Uruguayan. He has a big loyalty to that country. But obviously Mbappe's pace is gonna be dangerous. And it'll be interesting to see if Uruguay can open up. They did well in the previous game with 2 goals for Cavani. But for me, they are more defensive. And obviously, France are more attacking. So that might be a one-sided encounter. But you can win games like Sweden have proved by being defensive.
So what's the semi-final you see, Ashley, from that side of the bracket?
I don't think Uruguay will have enough without Cavani. I think France will go through. And I think Belgium will be too open. I think most people will probably pick Brazil and France, but at the end of the day, they know the World Cup's had loads of upsets and you can't call any game so far.
So we're not going to stick our neck out on that one. The other section of the draw, Eugene, of course, is the first game on Saturday is a game that I'm not going to ask Ashley about at the moment. He's given his view on Sweden against England. From a more neutral perspective, how do you foresee that clash panning out?
I think it's all up to England, I feel. England could have done better yesterday. I felt they should have finished the game in 90 minutes. Sweden are a more defensive unit, so I would be interesting to see what England would do to break Sweden's defense, because England were a bit slow yesterday in transition, so I would expect them to play more quicker. Otherwise, if they are slow, then Sweden will sit back, be happy, let England have the ball. So it's going to be tough, but if England can really play to their strengths, I would see England go through.
After that, Ashley, you will have a quarterfinal no one in the world could have called. Croatia at 20, already among the lower ranked teams to have made a quarterfinal in recent World Cup history. But they go up against a side which started this competition at number 70 and will have a boisterous backing of a packed stadium at Sochi in Russia.
Yeah, I think this is probably the quarterfinal that's the toughest to call. I think Croatia were lucky to get through against Denmark. I don't think they deserve to go through. Obviously, before that, they'd won three games and looked in great form. So there's question marks now about Croatia, where before you would have said Croatia will definitely win this. And then Russia have just got loads of momentum. Obviously, the crowd get behind them. They did what they needed to do in the previous game to do enough to get through, being defensive. But before that, obviously, they scored five goals in the first game, three in the second, and they've got a bit of momentum. So it'll be an interesting one. They know, the coach has been quite astute, changing the system in the last game. So this, I think, they'll fancy the chances. So this one could be an upset. You wouldn't be surprised if Croatia go through, but the momentum at the minute, I feel, is just starting to shift towards Russia.
All right, so all of it looks quite tough to call, barring, of course, England versus Sweden to you, Ashley Westwood. On that note, I will thank you, gentlemen, for a riveting look back at a riveting round of 16. That does it from us on this edition of Theatre of Dreams. Sleep is a commodity forgotten to all of us here, but we are utilizing the next 24 odd hours to catch up on our collective breath. Ashley Westwood and Eugeneson Lyngdoh, thank you as always for your time. Let's get some legs back in us, shall we, before embarking on further more drama. These two gentlemen will be back on Friday evening at 6:30 p.m. IST or 1 p.m. GMT as we dig into the final stretch of the 2018 FIFA World Cup.